With the explosion of AI, there's a lot of great ways to upscale your image nowadays. Tools such as Topaz Labs Gigapixel and Adobe Super Resolution, Hitpaw, Magnific AI. The only downside with those tools is that they're really expensive. Take Magnific AI for example. It will cost you $40 a month for the most basic plan, and then $99 a month to upgrade to the next tier, which is outrageous. Then you got Topaz Labs that will cost you about $199 to buy the tool, but with limited upgrades. Yep, like I said, not cheap. But what if I told you you can get just as good results with some free AI tools? These tools are so free that you don't even have to sign up to use them. Having said that, let's take a look at some of the best free AI upscalers that can compete and sometimes outperform their very expensive counterparts. By the way, this is the channel Artificially Intelligent, and if you like AI stuff or AI art, then you come to the right place, and please leave a like if you find this video most useful. Okay, let's get started. First, we'll start with DGB.lol. No, I didn't just say LOL out loud, but you heard me right. Instead of .com, they got .lol at the end of their address, which is pretty interesting and will probably help you remember this tool. This tool is perhaps one of the most robust in terms of added features other than upscaling out of the bunch. And the devs refer to it as a Swiss Army knife for advanced image processing and manipulation, which is a pretty accurate statement. This tool has AI background removal, vectorization, an image fixer, DPI enhancer or dots per square inch enhancer, an image type converter, and they even added a Sudoku generator, which, okay, that one's kind of random, but sure, why not? Along with all these high quality tools, you get an absolutely free and amazing upscaler that can upscale up to 6 times in a couple different styles as well, which should help get you the best upscale as possible. There's upscale options such as sharpness upscales, smooth, fine tuning, balance, or even cartoon for the anime and cartoon lover. And you can choose the upscale that best suits your images that you're uploading. I say images plural because you can upload about 25 images at once, so you can do some bulk upscaling with this site. Now, to upscale an image, you would simply just have to go to DGB.lol and then drag 1 or 25 images into the upload area, or you can also click on the upcloud icon here to upload it and then choose the style that you want to upscale in. I will choose the 6x sharp, and that's it. Voila, you have a great product that's grown 6x in resolution, which is pretty massive for an upscale. Real quickly, after clicking on submit, you'll be met with some options here, and you could either start a new task to do an additional upscale, or you can click on my files, which is also over here on the side here. So when you click on my files, you'll see all your files that are processing are in the queue. So this is me in the future, and I'm doing this on a Saturday, and there's like a 1 hour and 5 minute wait time. And so that's not typical, but it could go up that high. So that's the one downside of this tool, is that you could be waiting from 1 minute to 1 hour. But considering the quality it gives you and the fact that you can upload 25 files at once, it's not bad. Also, the estimated wait times are worst case scenario usually from my experience, whether it's people that weren't logged in on a profile and then they closed the browser or they stopped their upscale, whatever they did, it usually reduces the time. So I would recommend after 5 minutes clicking the refresh button to see if the time doesn't drop more than the expected wait time. Also, check out the quality that it produces, and it's definitely a great upscaler that can compete with the paid options out there. As you can see now, it says here the waiting time is 17 minutes. So you can look at this and see if you want to use it or not, depending on the wait time. Now, once you've started your upscale, you can go here into My Files. You'll see here that you'll have all your uploads here. And one thing you can do is actually click on the Compare button so you can see the quality before and after. Now, we're going to zoom in really close and look at the 6x upscale here, and you can see that it cleaned it up quite a bit. So it did a pretty good job at getting rid of a lot of the pixelation. But one thing you do notice is that it kind of smoothed out the picture. And so that might not be something you want. So you might want to lower the upscale or choose a different type of upscale. Now here's a different type of upscale that actually adds a little bit more noise to it. And so it actually added its own detail. Now this might be something you do like or don't like. You can just play with the different upscales to see which one's best for the picture that you have. Something great about this site, if you see here in the light green, you'll see that you have the full commercial rights. So it says no wires attached, which normally people say no strings attached, but okay. And most of our tools work in bulk. And so this is what you should know about this site, is that you'll have the commercial rights to the images that you upload, as long as you had the commercial rights when you uploaded them, of course. You have so many advanced tools at your disposal, including upscaling. And very important, you can upload and process in bulk, which saves a lot of time. It's a great free option that provides you excellent results, and you don't even have to log in or sign up. In fact, it's going to give you a temporary username so you can pick up your goods when it's done. But I would still recommend signing up so you can access your files even after clearing your cache or accidentally closing your browser, which would be bad if you're waiting like an hour. Yep, that would be bad. Like I said, there's a lot of other features on this site that you should check out. I'm not going to go into the details of all the different features. This is an Upscayl comparison video, but I'll put the first video that I made on this site in my description, which is still relevant. And just know that the wait times have changed significantly, and the site has ads all over now, which it didn't have before. With that video, we'll go over RGB to CMYK, as well as, you know, DPI enhancers and stuff like that, if you're interested. Next up is my personal favorite, which is Upscayl. And that's Upscayl with a YL. U-P-S-C-A-Y-L. No, I did not spell it wrong in the video. That's how it's spelled. I've been using this tool so long, maybe I'm spelling it wrong. Is there L-E in the end of ups? Whatever. With Upscayl, you can actually do bulk image 16 time upscales and even upscale an entire folder of images. I had to check 3 times to make sure this tool was actually free, because that's some insane free value. I know a lot of paid options that don't even do this. I actually paid for ClipDrop, which is Stable Diffusion site that also has upscaling, and it was $9.99 per month, and the wait time was the same as DGB.lol, which was kind of awkward, you know, considering I'm paying for it. Quality was also the same, so So yeah, Upscayl with a YL is extreme value. I also haven't seen any limitations so far in Upscayl, and it's basically upscale as many pictures as you want immediately on your PC without the use of internet or waiting on long queues. We're absolutely free. To access this tool, simply go to their website and click on the download icon here at the top right. Then choose Linux, Mac OS, or Windows to select the local installer appropriate for your OS. Soon they're going to offer this on any device, which means you can use it on your tablet or phone or your crazy unbranded PC that you got from wish.com, which means they're probably going to offer this as a service, and that's probably how they're going to charge people, because I mean, it's going to be extremely expensive to run it on their end for free. So they couldn't do that unless they got really deep pockets and don't care. But being able to run it locally for free, I love it. Cool, now go into your downloads folder where you downloaded your installer, then just double click on it and go through the motions until it installs completely and puts a shortcut on your desktop. And when you open it up, you should see this, and you'll notice right away that it's very simple. The user interface is sleek, simple, and needs no introduction. It's just very basic. However, I will say that there is a batch upscale radio button here, so you can choose an entire folder with pictures rather than individual images. I also want to point out here that in step 2, there's an option to select a different upscaling model. I personally like UltraSharp, which is one of the default models, but you can definitely try all of them. And you can also click the double upscale here for a 16 time upscale, which is a bit overkill, but I guess that's the point, right? If you hover over the blue information icon here, you'll get a little bit more information on double upscales and how I came to the information that this is a 16 times upscale. And of course, there's step 3, which is selecting the output folder, which is pretty self-explanatory, and then step 4, which is clicking the purple upscale button. Yes, it's spelled with a YL, which is going to start your upscale. Now, upscale produces some amazing result, and here is an image that I processed with an entire folder of images, and as you can see, it's simply amazing, and it's crazy that this tool is free. I'm actually still looking for the catch. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, which is the only con for this tool. Upscayl produces some great upscales, but also requires a great computer. With the thing so highly optimized now, I wonder if that's even a limitation for most people. On my RTX 4080, it takes about 5 to 10 seconds to do a normal upscale, and it takes me roughly 1 minute to upscale a picture from 1024 resolution to 19,000 resolution. Yes, I said it. 19,000, that's 19 with 3 zeros at the end. I will caution you though that pictures this big can end up being 500 megabytes each, or half a gigabyte or more. And I just want to put this in context, because that's for one picture. So if you do a bulk upscale with a folder of hundreds of images, you might be in some serious trouble when your PC runs out of overhead. But other than having to process the upscales locally on your PC, I don't see much of a downside to this tool. One amazing feature that I want to highlight is the ability to change models in step 2. I personally like the UltraSharp model, and I used it a lot when I used Automatic 1111. And now Comfy UI. Now, another benefit of being able to switch between models is that you could find more upscale models on Hugging Face, and you can search for the latest and greatest and then experiment with new models so you don't have to stick to the vanilla flavor of eSargan. With a bit of research, you'll probably find the next best thing in terms of upscaling, as it seems to pop up every other week. Just be careful with some of these experimental models, as some of their licenses do not allow commercial sale of any of the products that you make with them. UltraSharp is an example of this, and I'm not sure if they changed their licensing, but the last time I checked, it was for research only and not to be used commercially. So keep that in mind. So that's Upscayl with a YL at the end, and it's perhaps the quickest, easiest upscaler that I've worked with, and it produces some amazing results, and you can do some massive bulk upscaling with this, which is why I think it's AI gold. The only downside is that you gotta have a semi-decent graphics card that wasn't made like, you know, last decade ago. Yeah, nothing that utilizes AGP or something. Now you're probably like, say no more. If I have a crappy PC, I'll use DGB, and if I have a good PC, I'll use Upscayl, right? Wrong. I have a compromise for you between speed and quality, but it might be exactly what you need for free upscaling. So last but not least is Pixelcut. It's like if DGB and Upscayl had a digital baby. So you won't have to install this on your computer and rely on your GPU, but you also don't have to wait in line. However, you're gonna sacrifice a little bit in the Upscayl department. Something I have to mention is that it gets pretty confusing on what's free, because if you try to go over 4K, it will actually tell you to log in or pay for something. So don't go over 4K and don't try to edit anything over 4K, or it's gonna actually ask you for money. But if you stay below 4K, you'll actually get free stuff and you don't even have to log in. It produces perhaps some of the best results, but you're limited to a 4x upscale. But again, I've never waited in a long queue, and you don't have to install this. Typically on this site, upscaling takes about 30 seconds, but you have to do it one image at a time. If you want to do more, you actually have to pay for the premium plan, which is $9.99 a month. But that's dirt cheap considering this site has other tools such as image recoloring, AI shadows enhancing, or the ability to add lifelike shadows to your soulless AI generated images, and AI one-click background remover. Oh, it also has an AI magic eraser tool, so you can erase your ex-boyfriend from your old photos or ex-girlfriend. Man, I will say that this magic eraser tool works so good that I always get surprised every time I use it. However, you don't even need to pay or sign up to use this tool or most of the tools on this site, which is pretty interesting. Again, this tool is pretty amazing and it will get you some pretty good results that are the same as paid tools, if not better. So I'm just waiting for the rug pull when they tell you it's not free and you're like so used to using it. However, Pixelcut has been around for a while and that hasn't happened yet. As an added bonus, Pixelcut actually has a free upscaler that you can use with your mobile phone as well. They got an app for it, so that's pretty great as well. So that's Pixelcut, and it has some pretty good results, but you can't get over 4K, so I guess it's subjective on who you ask. If you're looking for better than 4K quality, just keep that in mind, because when you go over 4K, you always get asked to pay, and so a lot of people don't think it's free. So all of these tools are free and they're constantly improving. I remember in the past, like some of these models actually had lines if you looked really closely, which I don't see that anymore. I will do a short comparison at the end of this video that's like about a minute and do super close-ups of each different model or product, but they're all free and you can get started now, so why not make your own comparisons and just jump in there and start upscaling it. But that's it for this video, and if you like the content and if you thought it was very helpful and that you like the upscalers that I showed you, go ahead and leave a like. It helps me out big time. Thanks a lot for watching to the end of the video, and take it easy. Bye.
Just the tip with Daniel, that's how it begun. Now it's artificially intelligent. The name's been outrun. A YouTube channel that's not your usual fuss. Doesn't post often, but shares the best tools with us. With a touch of the 90s pop, we're taking it back. Talking about software and gadgets, that's a fact. Daniel's got the knowledge, he's our digital guide, keeping us updated, forever by our side. Artificially intelligent.